Hello there, everyone. So today I'm going to show you mashup from July Christmas. And I'm going to tell you that this time I have used several themes in my attempt to try to find the best theme. And I couldn't figure out the best possible theme without having Obelon in my team. And at this time I don't have Obelon. So I try my best to see what team should be the best. I try several setup and several position also. And my first team that I tried during this time was Jaden team, and I also use it at later team or later day also. And yep, I will show you this team first. It's not the same as Jaden Yuna team that I show you in June matchup. Because this time Yuna healing reduction by 50%, so I use Cloud instead. Cloud is good against majority of unit, and Cloud has Archer sub also, so he could use Balash and confirm hit shooting from higher position. So the first team I'm going to start with an easy to win team first, and then at the second part of the video I will follow it up with a difficult to win team, which is to say bad matchup against my team. So this is a good matchup for my team because among the missile unit, Jaden is at the top. Because Jaden has very high missile resistance, so none can shoot him, but he can shoot other. So when you fight between a missile user, Jaden will come out on top. So as you can see that the starting position is at the high ground. It is the usual position for a shooting team. To start off with, I pull Cloud back in order to keep Jaden above, but I was too late at this point because the time is running out. Opponent also used the same setup team as me, basically a Cloud sub Archer and another shooting unit. However, Jaden would come out on top when you compare to any shooting unit. So I don't even have to try so much on this situation. My team clearly has advantage. As you can see, the Phoebe usual position from the front is not out of reach from my Jaden attack, and that was one shot KO. So my team will still have Phoebe survive, but his team will not have Phoebe anymore, so it's a 3-on-2 now. I cast quick on Jaden. On that position, Cloud couldn't do anything but using Archer skill also. However, Cloud Archer skill, despite very high damage against other units, due to Jaden highly resistant against missile, Cloud couldn't do any damage on Jaden either. So basically, for that team, if he want to kill my Jaden, he have to come close to me. And he has to walk across that hill on the center, which requires jump 2 or jump 3 in order to pass it easily. And despite that, it might require 2 turns in order to pass that hill. So yep, my Jaden could stay here and be at a good position shooting them. my cloud sub Azure do not support shooting. He also had very heavy damage because cloud has a lot of ATK. He doesn't even need missile attack up. See, the opponent already realized that he couldn't win me no matter what because of the team setup already beside this map. So next we are going to fight in the second map with a team that is opposite, and this time it will be a bad map up for me instead. You can see they have Oberon and Ruel, so that primary element is Earth element. That will gain advantage against our Cloud. Cloud couldn't do anything much against them. And the position that we start this time is kind of gamble because the distance is very close and I didn't start up at the hill. Because at one point during the class match, I decided I want to start at the center instead. And I hurry up and use Lock Class Mastery to hasten off my unit because my Jadon required 2 turns in order to start shooting. I don't have much time to prepare for this. So I put the bell up on Jadon for AP Legion and then I follow it up right away with Phoebe Quick. You could notice that I have a hard time clicking on Jadon a little while ago because that the tree at the front is so annoying. In this map, when you click on the coconut tree, they will block your click ability and the game thought that you click on that coconut tree instead of your unit. The coconut tree was on top covering my Jadon position, so I was having a hard time to put quick on that. And you can see that this team has very high missile resistance up because his Oberon was using Nightblade sub, and that sub have an ability active that could increase huge amount of missile resistance up. So I decided other follow after Jadon, I could follow up with Cloud, and my Cloud will have to attack turn because of the Phoebe quick. Basically my startup had really high advantage here because I have 2 turns on Jadon and 2 turns on Cloud, but that team has only 1 turn on Oberon and 1 turn on Ruel. Usually if they don't have this high resistance or that they are not Earth element, I would have killed off their unit already because I have 4 turns, 2 on Cloud and 2 on Jadon. You know that how big the advantage is for that. But due to that high resistance, I couldn't deal much damage. Yep, let's see how it's continuing. His Oberon is using Dragoon Trick, basically a long period jump with level 1 skill, so that he will not be at the position for shooting. I believe that he decided this because he know that my team has really high speed and my team speed would outturn him again with double turn Jadon and double turn Cloud. Even though he has so high resistance, he could die from chaining. So he make a self decision by using Dragoon Tick and make an invincible jump. I could hit Ruel at this time instead, but I realized that Ruel was tied up just a ball, just a bit. his VC are resistant up also. They have resistant AOE up by 20 and single target resistant up by 20. My cloud effect when evolve from Ruel. Now he gain the haste. If I keep shooting, then Ruel would die. But what to worry would be Obelon afterward, because Obelon. Alright, my Jaden didn't get killed by that jump attack. That is good enough. So I will finish off Ruel, and then we are going to focus on Obelon 3-on-1 at this point. Yep. Despite my Jaden has little damage taken, but we are at the 3-on-1 position now. This Obelon is just one. Let's see how this unfolds. I do not know which target did he jump onto, either Phoebe or Cloud or Jaden, but I assume it would be Jaden because Jaden would die from the next jump. So in that decision, I put my spell on Cloud instead. I put Quick on him so that he can step up AP a lot, waiting Obelon to fall down by himself. I couldn't attack him now anyway, but my Cloud did need a lot of AP. He already spent all from killing their two units. My Jaden sadly has a lot of JP from Caesar Bell, but he probably about to die soon. It would be lucky and would be long decision for opponent if he didn't kill off Jaden right now. I couldn't cast my healing spell either, because in this map, healing reduction 50%. So I just give speed buff to Phoebe. At least this is all he could do before getting killed, as I expect. My Phoebe already ran off quick. I have my choice to use Meteo on Obelon, but it doesn't deal so much damage either. This Obelon doesn't have AP right now, it may be my good chance. So he decided that he would put Obelon up in order to avoid getting attacked. I will use my Cloud LB to deal damage as much as possible on him. 2000. It considered a bad damage, but not bad consider that Obelon is resist against Earth Element a lot. So Cloud generally just doing that much is good enough. His Meteor hit, so now we are gangbang on Obelon 2-on-1. Keep pushing the attack and we could win. Yep, Meteor again. No, actually, no. I put head on Cloud instead. My card got a effect. What? But that's what an AP drain. Obelon drain my all of my Cloud AP, and it's kind of weird. My Cloud didn't have that much AP at all, but he drained more than what I have. Anyway, his Obelon is about to die now, a while ago, but luckily he got counter with the drain attack, so my 3000 hit give him drain back for 1700. My Meteor missed him. He just decided he want to jump during my Meteor turn, else that would have killed him already. for this, but I know that he probably aim for my crowd, but I couldn't do anything against it because it's a invincible time frame, and that my is a lock jump, so you couldn't avoid it. Only one thing you can do is to let him return to the ground. And see, that lock jump is crazy. It's deal so heavy damage on my crowd. And I want to say that I make a mistake here because I make a bad decision, so I lose. What I could have done actually would be that to cast a meteor on the position where he will come back after his jump. However, I was too frustrated on that invisible jump and I make a wrong decision. So you can see that this is a good map and I have to give price for that guy. So that's all for me. If you like this, please click like, and it would be an honor for me if you could help sharing it. Thank you for watching. See you later.